We're back. I noticed. Seems like maybe you still have some pirate hardware in your mouth. Is that right?
Yeah, the teeth are still in.
Yeah. And why was it? You're getting ready to do the next one?
We start up on Pirates 3 in a couple of weeks.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
They can't wait to spend their money. But I mean, will you ever take those out?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think I'll have to at some point. The problem is that every time I go to a dentist, they demand that I get in the chair and they have to perform a root canal or something horrible.
Yeah, you don't want that.
No.
But, you know, it's just as cool as you are without the teeth, you're even cooler with the gold teeth. Just unbelievable. How's the family?
Great.
Yeah. And are, as I remember, you were all at one time, perhaps still are, living in the south of France?
Yeah, between the States and the south of France and, various other little...
What are the ages of the children now?
My daughter, Lily Rose, is 7, and my boy, Jack, is 4.
And when you were here once before, you described them. They were much younger then.
Yeah.
It was like living with drunks.
It kind of still is the same.
Yeah. And what about these kids and their dad in the big Pirates of the Caribbean movie? Is that a tremendous thrill for them?
Not especially, you know.
Really?
Well, they're sort of used to it, you know. They've grown up around it, so, I mean, they don't really notice the teeth. They don't notice the...
Right.
You know, they just sort of see me as Captain Jack. It's like, oh, yeah, Papa, hi.
It's just what Dad does.
Kind of deal, yeah.
Yeah. And what are you doing with the rest of your summer? Are you spending it here or in Europe?
We spent a little time in the Bahamas after Pirates 2.
Tell me about the place in the Bahamas. This is fascinating.
Oh yeah, it's,
you purchased an island?
I did, in fact, yeah.
Wow, I didn't know you could do that.
Neither did I.
Yeah. Well, tell us how this came about.
I I'd always kind of had that in the back of my mind, that idea, you know, living on a desert island, as we all do, probably. So.
Yeah.
And this thing showed up, and I snatched it.
Is it large? How big an island is it?
It's about 45 acres, something like that.
Pretty good size.
Nice size, you know, a few beaches and stuff, and.
And it's just you and your family there?
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. And how do you get to the island?
Well, you could take a boat or a seaplane.
Yeah, and the seaplane sounds great. Have you done that?
I'm not ready for that yet. skidding on the water.
Yeah. And what do you do when you're on the island? Because you're there when you're there.
Oh, yeah, absolutely nothing. Nothing.
Yeah, yeah.
Kids run around playing the sand, you know.
And I'm guessing that one of the great wonders of the experience is the night sky. It must be tremendous.
Incredible. Oh, Milky Way. Yeah. You know, it's insane, yeah.
Yeah. I got a bid in on a place on Staten Island. Kind of a timeshare thing. Hoping that goes through.
I'll go in halves with you.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, who do you talk to for advice when you're buying an island, for God's sakes?
Well, yeah, that's the thing. I was very lucky, you know. My old pal, bless him, Marlon Brando, was... when I told him, you know, I said, I think I'm going to buy this island. Mm-hmm. And he immediately sort of broke into this whole thing about, you know, well, what's the elevation? What's the highest elevation? What's this? What's that? What's, you know, water makers, solar power, all the questions I couldn't answer. So he asked me to get all this stuff together for him, and he advised me.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah, he was terrific about it.
So he was kind of like he was working for Century 21 or something. The guy, he had an island in the South Pacific, right?
Yes, down in, in Tahiti, yeah.
Yeah. Were you friends with him? Did you know him for a long time?
We met, he was about 70, I guess, so it was last 10 years of his life, yeah.
When you were younger, was he meaningful professionally to you? Did you look up to him as an actor, an icon, a guy that you wanted to be like?
No, he was always someone I admired greatly, but I never. My heroes were not particularly actors when I was growing up.
Who were your heroes?
It was sort of all over the place, you know, range from either, you know, musicians or writers or painters or Evel Knievel or guys like that.
We don't really need to sell any more tickets.
Do we not?
But we are going to show a clip here of the film, and you must have the thing memorized now. What clip is this going to be?
I think it has something to do with when I'm loading the pearl up to go out into the waters, and a young pirate arrives.
Okay.
Something like that.
Here it is, Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man's Chest. It's in theaters now, struggling along.
Captain Sparrow.
Come to join me, crew, lad. Welcome aboard.
I'm here to find the man I love.
I'm deeply flattered, son, but my first and only love is the sea.
Meaning William Turner, Captain Sparrow.
Elizabeth, hide the rum.
You know, these clothes do not flatter you at all. It should be a dress or nothing. I happen to have no dress in my cabin.
Jack.
Oh, golly. Yeah, but, I mean, it must be a thrill for you to be in a film that just is huge. I mean, this really is the definition of blockbuster. And for actors, I guess the craft and execution of that comes first. But nonetheless, the recognition must be very, very flattering.
Oh, I mean, very much so. I mean, it's very touching that, you know, so many people have gone to yeah. see the film. And it's really because of the people who have gone to see these movies that we were able to make a 2 and a 3.
Yeah, you know? Yeah.
It's because of the audience, because of the people who pay their money to go see him.
Great to see you again.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Johnny Depp, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back with the Spinners.